Good afternoon, myself Bukya Pawan Kumar. I am going to start a lecture series on electrical resistivity method. Basically, electrical resistivity method, what are the content which we are going to follow in the upcoming days is what is electrical resistivity method and the instrument electrical resistivity meter and the uses of the electrical resistivity meter and the application of electrical resistivity method and the research behind which I had done till now. I'll be explaining the research what I had done. And basically, electrical resistivity method is a surface geophysical method. It helps us to know the subsurface ground profile. The subsurface ground profile can be measured by many ways. Many subsurface methods are there, like seismic method and magnetic methods, gravity methods, and this is an electrical method, electrical resistivity method. So it uses the electrical resistivity meter as a instrument, and it helps us to get the profile of the soil. So now we are going to know about what is electrical resistivity method in brief manner. So electrical resistivity method contains four probes. Like, this is a sample one. Now we are having an advanced techniques. I'll be explaining to you later on. The sample one contains the standard one contains four electrodes. In outer two electrodes we are going to pass current, either it is a AC current or DC current, and we are going to measure the current which is passing through it. And in inner two electrodes we are going to measure the voltage difference. Basically, it is generated like in outer two electrodes when we are passing the current waves passes like this from this electrode to this electrode in outer two. And due to these current sources, the equipotential lines are generated for outer two electrodes, and there is a generation of potential difference in inner two electrodes. So in inner two electrodes we are going to get voltage, and in outer two electrodes we are going to get current, how much current is it is going to pass. So from these two, from basic Ohm's law, we are going to get R equal to V by A, resistance offered by the soil. And after getting resistance offered by the soil, there is a constant called multiplying constant. It varies according to different types of various types of methods which are used in the electrical resistivity method, like various types of arrays are there. So the instrument is same and the setup will change for every method which we are going to use. So after multiplying constant with resistance, we are going to get the resistivity. For this arrangement, we are going to get the resistance at this point. As I am saying it in 1D. So there are two types, like in 2D, 3D, we are going to have it. But I am discussing about only 1D. So in 1D method, we are going to get the profile like this, like this soil, like this. Like, what are the layers and what may be the resistivity of the various layers. And from this, when we interpret through semi-log graph, or when we interpret through various other softwares, we are going to get depth and resistivity of that profile. It will help us in like differentiating various layers of the soil, and we can identify the water table. Like, through experience we'll get it. I'll tell you how to get the water table depth, and like partially we can know the water may be present there by interpreting the data which we have got from resistivity, resistivity data which we have got from the survey. So coming to the point, what are the uses of the electrical resistivity method? The electrical resistivity method is used for finding groundwater depth and at what depth the water table is present. There are various uses of electrical resistivity method, like we are going to get the profile of the soil which is present underneath. We don't know how soil is like underneath, so we'll get the profile of that soil. The applications of the electrical resistivity method is we can apply this data to various hydrological and hydrogeological purposes. So I'll explain to you that later. And while coming to the research, I'll be explaining the research which I had done on the electrical resistivity method. Basically, I had done finding the subsurface properties of soil through electrical resistivity method also by using Archie's law. And coming to this various methods of electrical resistivity method, like these are not methods, these are the various arrays which are followed in electrical resistivity method, like Wenner arrays, Clemmerger array, pole-pole array, pole-dipole array. These arrays I am going to explain to you in detailed manner. It doesn't like electrical resistivity method is the same thing, but the arrangement of the electrodes varies in these four methods. So in coming classes we are going to learn part by part of this electrical resistivity method.